Hey folks, this is Bastian Slot, and welcome finally to Chaos Theory Mode. We're going to start tackling each of the films in order. I know it says 100% on all of them already, that's a dirty rotten lie, do not believe it. So, we're kicking things off with Jurassic Park. Now, I will admit, this is the only one I have actually completed to completion. Yeah, already. But the idea behind this, I've seen a lot of comments from people today who have people who started getting into Chaos Theory having done the campaign, maybe a little bit of challenge, and people are actually struggling quite a lot with the Jurassic Park Chaos Theory because it throws these all new mechanics at you. It can be a little bit obtuse and confusing at the start. So the hope is, especially for this first episode, is that this is kind of also going to be a bit of a beginner's guide to Chaos Theory Mode and to Jurassic Park specifically. And then hopefully you can just kind of follow along with what I'm doing if you're struggling at home, and hopefully this will help. And of course, for everyone else who just wants to watch me, we'll just have a good time playing Jurassic Park Chaos Theory as well. Sound like a plan? Sounds like a plan. Let's get started. And inevitably, we have a really cool introduction video.
The mosquito, frozen in time for millions of years, and trapped within it. Well, that discovery would change our world. For a while, we thought that this was as close as we could get to dinosaurs. Turns out, we were wrong. Years of research into how to complete the DNA sequence for a dinosaur led us to this. Life unlike anything seen on this planet for 65 million years. Jurassic Park. We know how well that went, but what if someone like you had been there to temper some of that rampant hubris? For Jurassic Park to succeed, you're going to need to make sure it's safe for all your guests. This is the adventure of their lifetime. We don't want it to be their last.
All these intro videos just so incredibly well done, so hype building. I just wish I had licensed music on, but I can't. I need to pay rent. Actually, I don't even need to pay rent right now, but I can't. I need to buy sweets. Okay?
Wonderful, isn't it? This is a paradise, but it is missing what it once had. Until we bring them back, this place will show people something spectacular. Dinosaurs, no longer confined to our imaginations. Dinosaurs in the flesh. And the moment people see them, that moment of astonishment, of magic. Well, you're going to be a part of that spectacle. Jurassic Park will open on schedule, and the world will be as it once was. A land of the dinosaurs.
Lovely.
Ah, good, good. Glad to see you getting settled in. I want to introduce you to Lily Halford, who is our Director of Operations here at the park. She'll get you up to speed.
Thank you, Dr. Hammond.
John, please.
Oh, right then. As Dr. Hammond, John, has already told you, our goal is to get Jurassic Park fully operational as quickly and safely as we can. We are literally doing things that were considered impossible, so it will be a challenge.
Making the impossible possible. Yes, yes, I rather like that.
Okie dokie.
We will need to prep the facility for the dinosaurs. Begin with a functioning visitor center and a science center. And remember that both must be connected to pathways. Oh, and power as well.
I can see that all is in good hands. Do carry on.
We'll keep you updated.
Splendid. Absolutely splendid.
Fake John Hammond is so happy. So basically the idea is I'm going to try to explain just a little bit more than I usually do about what I'm doing and why I'm doing it as we go through the game. Really, when it comes to the very start, we're just going to be following it. This, it does act as a tutorial to an extent to this game mode, so we're going to just basically do what Lily tells us, essentially. Kick things off, so we're just gonna, oh no, already scrap the video, undo everything, it can't be trusted. I made a weird angle path. There we go, that's better. Let's just connect all these together. Yeah, don't need to worry too much about this. You get a little bendy path in there. One thing I like to do though, right, this is my favorite thing to do. I'm gonna come out of here a little bit. We're gonna go bendy, and we're gonna link perfectly on, aren't we? Yes, we are. Beautiful. Straight into Bend. Lovely stuff.
Top geneticist. Top. Dr. Henry Wu. I should expect that you'll be meeting him soon. That is, if you haven't already.
Let's do the research.
I'm settled in and ready to get started. So if we're to get the dinosaurs we want, we first need a hatchery. If you could construct one, then my staff and I can get to work.
The game actually gives you incredible scientists. Faster synthesis, extraction, incubation, and expeditions. These are really good traits. Let's say, does anyone like ghosts by any chance? Anyone like ghosts or aliens? He likes the ski. Oh, no, they're all boring. We'll go with fluid for this. It doesn't really matter, really. Just looking to match up the skill points here with this. You can do a little bit extra and knock down the duration. As you can see, that the more scientists you have working on a task, the more excess skill points you have, then the quicker it'll be. But with these early game tasks, they're really quick, and all you'll do is tire your scientists out. So you don't need to really worry about doubling up on tasks and stuff like that. Just to get the minimum points, get your research on the go. Any second now. There we go. Build a hatchery. Again, we're just going to keep following it all along, doing it in the right spot that the game tells us. Trying to make a sexy little path. Why aren't you being bendy? There we go. And I want that to kind of go like straight across from there and look good. There we go. That's exactly what we're looking for. Already, it's worth keeping in mind, this is where your dinosaurs are going to be. Inevitably, this is where your guests are going to be as well, because you're going to have viewing areas here and tours and stuff like that. So it's worth just keeping in mind, nice straight paths, lots of room, helps with building shops in the future.
Velociraptors. Yes. We're going to start with raptors. I know you may have concerns, but both John and I agree that they represent some of our most viable candidates. You'll need to synthesize their eggs using the available genome research I've provided. And of course, let me know the results the moment you have them.
You're a madman, Wu. You're a madman. So we've got a faster synthesis. So the egg-creating process is broken down into synthesis and incubation. Synthesis is the first part, and then when you've got the egg clutch, it's incubation. So we'll just stick with that. Minus 50%. Lovely stuff. A little bit of time. Quick little gaze around the map, which is beautiful. You can see that this area here has been organized to look like it is from Jurassic Park, where there's that little river lake area in front of the visitor center. Actually, there should also be, if I recall correctly, a bunch of trees here. And we'll block off this area here. There we go. More like that. Lovely stuff. Oh no, the eggs! Oh no! Can I click it, please? What's going on?
Our first synthesis was unsuccessful. Which means that we clearly have room for improvement, but we don't stop. We get better. I've identified some areas in the synthesis process that need further research. See what you can learn at the Science Center and get back to me.
I love that we can see inside the buildings now. I think that's a really cool little change. So we're going to hit tab, hop into our research and grab improved synthesis. Not something you have to worry about on other maps. It's just meant to be a little bit of a Jurassic Park flavor more than anything else. And we'll put fluid to task once again. What does fluid like? It's got micropaleontology. That's cool. Get to work, fluid. It's a great name. Not doing anything else yet. Not worrying too much about, you know, other buildings and stuff like that quite yet. We'll get to that in just a moment. Come on, fluid. 10 whole seconds to do this viable research. Crazy. And now we can discard our eggs, synthesize dinosaur, and make some raptors.
We're beginning with raptors? I'm not sure we're ready.
Every precaution has been taken. I'm following the science, and these dinosaurs are our best chance at success. We've learned so much, and we'll continue to learn as we move forward.
Yes, yes, of course. And I do understand your concern, Ms. Halford.
Every dinosaur carries a certain amount of risk.
And it's our job to mitigate it as much as possible.
Keep the lawyers out of my hair and the dinosaurs safely and happily within their enclosures, and you shall have my eternal gratitude.
Dr. Hammond, does that mean we have your authorization to proceed?
Yes. Most enthusiastically.
I've got to say, the John Hammond impersonator, he's not bad. He's a lot better than Chris Pratt. He's a little bit high-pitched, I think, for Hammond at times. Hammond isn't always that high-pitched. but he's generally pretty good. Now, I've got to say, I lucked out a little bit here. My Velociraptor, having three no negative trait raptors is super lucky, and I think six is like a full batch, so this is very, very fortunate. All I'd recommend here is you don't need five or six raptors. You don't need to spend that much money. The goal here really is to get the park open as fast as possible, because while the park isn't open, you are losing money constantly. It's just like challenge mode. You need to get park open and going ASAP. I would also recommend not taking aggressive raptors. Your raptors will fight regardless. We'll get to that when it happens. But if you can avoid the aggressive ones, I would suggest it, because they would fight more often. We're going to go for three. It's a nice number. We can pick all these non-trait ones. If you have to pick up, you know, intolerant and stuff like that, it's honestly not a big deal at all. And we want faster incubation. Lovely stuff. Time, speed, power, and so forth. And this might be a good time. Can we do a little research? Yeah, so the first thing I always research is here. So you want to go into power. Again, you want to go into improved power technology. And this is going to mean we no longer have to rely on these backup generators. I know people out there who are hemorrhaging cash because they keep refilling these backup generators. And if you look at this thing, to resupply it costs $400,000. It is super expensive. It's crazy expensive, and I have no interest in it. So what you want to do is research a power station, and we're going to go ahead and place that over there and use that from now on. Backup generators are good if there's a storm. That is their only purpose. Do not use them to power your park. Now, before we do anything else, the second thing we're going to do is split this habitat. This habitat is way too big for velociraptors, and raptors are crazy and they won't live with anything else. So what I'm going to do, this is kind of an old Jurassic World Evolution 1 trick. I don't recommend doing this specifically, but I'll tell you why I'm doing it. So I'm just going to divide this exhibit. Raptors probably need less room than the herbivores. So let's go along like there. I messed that line up, didn't I? Yep, can't do that. Heartbreak. So we're going to go along like this. And the idea is that we put a gate here. And then we open that gate. And that becomes our velociraptor habitat, basically. The gate hasn't been built yet, but this will be our raptor habitat. We'll have a gate over here on the right-hand side as well. And by using gates, we can control where the dinosaurs go. Now, because this is Evolution 2, you can't just release your dinosaurs via airlift and plonk them down over here and plonk them down over here. So maybe the gates aren't strictly necessary. The only reason I'm doing it is because I really like the exit animations. And, you know, I'll buy a gate to see an exit animation, essentially. That is the only good reason to do it. Otherwise, you can just use the airlift and you'll be absolutely fine. So, the gates are open, and let's release our raptors. Absolute beauties. Oh, in the light as well. Stunning. Okay.
Even with Dr. Wu's assurances, we'll want the proper response teams in place. I'm not saying anything will go wrong. I'm just erring on the side of caution. We can start with a ranger post, build one inside the velociraptor enclosure, then create a response facility. From there, assign a ranger patrol to the post.
Okay, okay, so I built my response facility here. I've decided this area here on the left towards visitor center, because visitor center is cool but not actually important. This area here is going to be our maintenance section or staff section, all that kind of jazz, and all the room over here can be left for guests later on. We're also going to build, you'll have seen it just finished, we're going to build ourselves a small power station. I'm going to try to cram it in there, but it's not going to work because of those beloved building constraints back again. So I'm just going to stick this over here. Again, the idea is just get it away from over here. Like, this line will not be crossed, is the general plan, and we're just going to rig up all of our buildings with a little bit of power. It's going to cost you a little bit here. You know, it will, in the short term, be more expensive than using the temporary generators, but in the long term, it saves you an absolute blimmin' fortune. And it depends on you personally. Me, I quite like the pylons. They give a bit of height. It looks more Jurassic Park-y in a way, if you know what I mean. Anyways, we've got our ranger post, built that in the middle of the habitat. We have to press R. We need to rename our ranger team, first of all, so these are the drive bobies, of course, as always. And these are Bob. And these are the Fly Girls. The Fly Girls. Funnily enough, I think the Bobies joke you guys probably don't know about, because I think it came in my first Jurassic Park Chaos Theory, and obviously I'm recording this instead. So, Drive Bobies have been assigned. There we go. Lovely stuff.
We need the animals comfortable in their enclosures. The less they feel stress over their captivity, the more they'll begin to act within their expected behaviors. This is better for them, and obviously better for us. Check on the raptors' welfare, and remember, they're still getting habituated to their new enclosure.
Okay, so we stuck in a live prey feeder, and we're going to add a little bit of forest. Oh, also.
There's much entertainment and educational value in the park.
Daisy.
If our visitors cannot see our dinosaur. I mean, what's the point, really? If not to see these majestic animals up close.
Well, we can construct viewing galleries, which should provide the guests with what you're after, John.
They won't believe their eyes.
Which is exactly what we want.
Precisely my thoughts as well, Lily. And why they'll want to keep coming back, time and time again, to Jurassic Park.
Our dinosaurs offer priceless memories for a reasonable fee.
Ah, yes. Now you're getting it.
I always think Lily sounds oddly aggressive there. That's exactly what would they want. She sounds evil. Anyway, so we put in our little ranger post. Let's pause for a sec. Put in our ranger post, put in our live prey, added some water, added some forest. Check on our raptors. They're looking very content. Very handy if you've not been doing it. If you go into edit environment here, it will tell you with little highlighted blue icons exactly what the raptors need. Bear in mind that when they're first released, they need a little time to acclimate and to spread around the territory. So don't, you know, rush if they're if it looks like they're a little sad from the get-go. They will eventually calm down if you've got the right stuff. Raptors are super easy to take care of. You don't need tons of room or anything like that. They will try to kill each other. We'll get to that in a little bit. But first things first, we need a viewing gallery. Also want to point out, if you just keep an eye on this backup generator, you'll see it never drops below 6 fuel anymore. Anywho, viewing gallery. Now the important thing here, more important than anything else if you want to be a successful park builder, really, is to make sure it's even. So we need to make sure that arrow is nice and in the center, like so. Please, yeah, a little bit to the left, but that's okay. So we're going to get our viewing gallery built. That should cover most of the habitat. And we'll have a tour going through here later, so it's not that big a deal. Feeling good. Feeling sexy. Gonna get a little bit more research on the go as well.
We need to get a paleo medical facility in place to ensure any sick or injured dinosaurs can be taken care of.
That's a good idea. We need to keep our dinosaurs healthy.
Okay, that will happen automatically. The next most important thing after a power station I would recommend is a staff center. This is how you're going to rest your staff, because inevitably that will be an issue. And down the line, it lets you train your staff and increase their numbers and stuff like that. So I really recommend picking up a staff center. My other favorite one to pick up is efficiency upgrades tier 1, and specifically because of science center extraction capacity and Expedition Center improved yield. Now these will cost you a little bit of money, but in the long term they'll save you a ton of time and a ton of cash. And it basically means usually you can only extract up to 10 slots of fossils at once. With this you can extract 17, and improved yield gives you like 50% more yield on your fossils. And that doesn't just mean fossils, that's going to mean extra, you know, gold deposits, alluvial deposits, things you can sell. So I'd pick up both of these researchers. You might have to wait a little bit. I've looked out. I've got really good scientists, it must be said. So it might take a little bit longer for you, but I would recommend across these early stages picking up both of those research items. And we've got... Oh, look at that. Just, you know, let's line that up. Make it sexy. There we go. You got to make it sexy. Them's the rules. And I think what we need, more important than anything else, is a little raptor sign, you know? Bam. Can't see a bloody thing. Fantastic. So, paleo medical on the way. A couple of research items on the way. Feeling good.
I'm in need of more genetic samples than we have here at the park. We can send out expeditions of our own to gather fossils, but what we really need is for you to get an expedition center under construction. Then, we can extract DNA from these new fossils gathered in the field and rebuild an even more diverse set of dinosaur genome sequences. This should be your priority.
So in case you were curious what I was doing there, the pylon was in the way, so I just shuffled it out of the way, basically. And we're going to build our expedition center. We're also going to build a staff center. It's absolutely going to be necessary anyway. You may as well grab that. I saw you just for a second, you cheeky little blighter. I saw glory. There we go, that'll do. Again, just really trying to cram all these buildings in the rough area. Trying to just... you know, there's no transport rating in the Jurassic Park era, so you don't have to worry about this big, long path to enter your park. We will need this area over here later on, but this little bit here can all be staff stuff and it's totally okay. So, before we go do our expedition, we need to upgrade our expedition center. We're going to take that improved yield up to 50%. Crazy stuff, and it's dirt cheap. Definitely want that. And we're also going to go to our science center, click on the upgrade tab here at the top, and we're going to grab extraction capacity. Now, this is super expensive, $1 million, but I promise you it is super, super good. And if I can make it work, you guys can make it work. They really need to fix the draw distance on this game. It is crazy bad. Anyways, let's get our expedition on the go. So we're looking for Triceratops. We're going to use our faster expedition lad. They love marine reptiles. Who doesn't? And again, these people don't contribute much because their logistics skills are really low. We're just going to stick with our one person. The other thing we could be doing right now is more research, but there isn't anything else I feel is drastically important right now, basically. There's other things that will become important, like better shops and stuff, but not this moment in time. Also, I love how this looks. Look at that lighting. This map is gorgeous. The light effects are just... look at that. Look how far away into the distance that goes. All the maps have such a cool sense of scale to them. Look at that moon. It's like a Majora's Mask thing going on. It's about to catapult into the earth and take us all out. So we got our fossil. And look, right. Usually, if you didn't get that upgrade I just talked about, you could get this and this and this. And you'd be maxed out. 10 done. But we've got 17 now. So I'd recommend obviously focusing on the fossils, basically. Get all of those you can, like so. And then if you've got a little extra gap, sell some osmium, sell something else, you know. A lot of people have asked about how do you sell these without spending money, and you can't, but the idea with selling things is to fold it into your general extraction process. You know, you don't sell this on its own. You sell it whilst you're analyzing all these fossils over here. And we can use faster extraction, and whilst that's going on, we're going to go on another dig, because we want to hit 100%, because I'm not a madman, basically. I'm not sure, actually, in this game, how much the different... I'm going to take a look at that. So where's our trike? All right, we'll wait till trike hits the next percentage, and we're going to take a little look. I don't know for sure, and I knew more so in the last game. You're just eating the grass. I'm going to choose to believe you're herbivorous. I'm going to call you... What's a vegan name? Rain. With an E. There you go. Just like in Friends. Little reference for you folks there. So let's check our trike. There it is. Releasing survival rate
into an enclosure. I want to observe these animals in the wild. I mean, as wild as we will allow.
What's this here? I actually don't know what that is. Oh, that unlocks more modifications. Okay, so modifications allowed, and survival rate. Are those the two things that change? Let's find out. So you see, we didn't get a big haul this time, so. We can sell all these fossils off. We're going to get a lot of cash doing that. And already that little extra one we got starts to pay off a little bit. Now, what I find, personally, I don't know if it's true or not, but what I find is that, you see, so you can see that these are yellow. That means I've not been to them yet. And if they're grey, it means I have. If you're going to a dig site repeatedly and you're not getting dinosaur fossils, I find it really helps to just try a new dig site that has the same fossils. So that's Triceratops and that's Triceratops, but this one we hadn't been to before, so we'll go give that one a go instead. Otherwise, you can go to the same dig site like 3 or 4 times and never get the dino fossils you need, and it's super frustrating. So that would be my next top tip. My other top tip would be to build some rocks, because rocks are cool. Oh yeah. Undeniably awesome, I think. Do a little rotate and then oh, wait for it. Hey, stop it, you two. They've been very chill. You can see having, like, you know, none of these aggressive dominant genes, the raptors have chilled out a little bit. I will say this is surprisingly chill. You may have to do some flying back and forth with the MVU, but I find if you've got less dinosaurs and no aggressive genes, you may only have to do it once or twice to say kind of establish dominance, and then they'll chill out a little bit. Right, let's check on those new fossils. See how much better that is already? Hopefully this is enough. We can see, yes, we're going to get 25%, as you can see from this right-hand side when we hover over it. No more room, so we're going to have to hold on to these for a little bit longer, but let's... you see, this is a problem. So what we're going to do, we're going to use our synthesis lass, Izawi. She's going to get to work on that. And this is why we need our staff center. We're going to rest... are to staff members like so. I'm also going to rename it to the Chill Zone, because I feel like if it was called the Chill Zone, you'd walk in already chill, you know what I mean? So at this point, we can hire more staff. It's up to you if you want to do this. It will eat into your funds a little bit. Personally, I like to do it, and I'm going to do it. And what I like to do is look at where the gaps are in my staff. So at the moment, we've got two people really good at genetics, only one good at welfare, one good at logistics, so maybe it makes sense to get another logistics and another welfare person. And let's just see who we've got. We've got a good logistics generalist there. Not the fantasticest of traits, though. I don't like generalist as a trait. It's okay early game, but it hurts later on. None of these are fantastic. Although, reduced task time for welfare is pretty cool. Their favourite dinosaur is the Tapajara. Right, you can't be trusted. You're out. I'm going to get the generalist for now. This is the kind of person I would maybe fire later on, because I find that better traits become more important later in the game. Who else did I want? I wanted another welfare person, right? There's no one really great at that. Maybe we'll pick up cheaper synthesis. None of you are inspiring me. I'm just going to get another genetics one. For now, only temporary. Conde. What do you like, Conde? You have a fear of dinosaurs. You're working at Jurassic Park, lad. What do you think's going to happen? So, we've got our fossils analysing, and what I like to do here, because as I mentioned, the whole goal here to an extent is get this park open. And now maybe on your first try through you won't know what's expected, but one of the goals in this is to have several species of dinosaur. I think you've got to have four. And I'd recommend a lovely Struthiomimus. It's nice and easy, it's dead cheap to get, and I shouldn't have sent that person. Super cheap to get, will live with anything, super easy to handle, and the point is not to get the most high-value dinosaurs yet, the point is to get dinosaur species variety into your parks. That would be... I would recommend this order. Raptor, Trike, Struthi, and then the other one will come to later. You have to stick around for that one, okay? I'm not just throwing these little hints and tricks out willy-nilly. No willies, no nillies here, I tell you. I need more rocks. One more rock. I get one rock every 5 minutes. Those are the rules. someone just pop over there. Anyways, Trike. So I want to have a look at this, actually. I'm very curious. So survival rate is still the same. But you can see that it's basically unlocking genome potential. Nothing too exciting. Faster synthesis, fantastic. And we'll check in our generalists. Generalists are okay because you can kind of just throw them on every task, you know. And we'll get that task popping off. Lovely stuff. Our expedition is still on the way. Our trikes are on the way. We're going to open this gate up as well. We're also going to prep for our trikes a little bit. So all we need to do for that is get a ranger post. Pachonka-chonk. Sorry. And we're going to assign the bobies to that. And we want to stick a gate here between the two habitats as well. Got some fossils from our Struthi. Oof, not many though. Not a great haul, must be said. But this is a good opportunity to sell all the other stuff we're getting. And if you're watching this thinking, wow, you're getting a lot of stuff to sell, you're lucky so-and-so, that's because we put that upgrade on nice and early. That's going to end up really paying off for us in the long term. Now, we need a bit more Struthi, so we're going to do what I said last time. We're not going to send out to the same dig site. We're going to go to a different dig site, and hopefully that's going to help us get a little bit more. We're also going to, as you can see, our staff are a little bit tired. We're just going to give Asari a little bit of a break. I'm going to hop back over here. We're going to incubate some dinosaurs. Now, that one's fine. Aggressive. Weak is fine. Weak is fine. Okay, so, again, I tend to avoid aggressive if you get the option. Maybe you don't. You know, you've got two or three eggs and they're all aggressive or something like that. I think if you've got one or two dinosaurs, you're absolutely okay at this point in time. You've got to keep in mind, more dinosaurs actually cost you more money at the end of the day. And, you know, if you want to get your park open and still have some funds in the bank, you don't necessarily need to worry too much about having tons of dinosaurs. It's more about the species variety. I'm really surprised my raptors haven't killed each other yet. Like, I'm mildly blown away by that. I cannot believe. Whoa, whoa! What the hell was that? I think it drove into the goat. And it just... What? That was mad. Alright, fossils have extracted. We got our next set. So let's grab this and this. That should hit, yeah, you can see there, 23% more. That hits 100. We can sell this. We can sell this. Making lots of cash. Now, we are going to need one more species of dinosaur. My recommendation is not Pachyrhinosaurus for two reasons. Number one, it won't get along with the Triceratops. And number two, they kill each other all the goddamn time. So we're going to go for the Parasaurolophus, which will live happily with the trike. And with the Struthiomimus. So we can get a nice triple herbivore habitat going on. That means we don't need to pay for extra ranger posts. We don't need to, you know, build too much further out. Yada, 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 yada. Right. Triceratops time. Cool. You're all so beautiful. I love you all so much. They are so gorgeous. They really are.
With so many moving parts, I want to make sure we don't lose sight of our reason for being on the island in the first place. The dinosaurs. Their lives come by our hands, and now they rely on us for their continued existence. This is our responsibility, and one we cannot take lightly. I want you to be sure that our dinosaurs are as comfortable as possible.
I've just realized I had this gate. Oh, the gate's not open. Is the vehicle has gone through? But there's no vehicle. Oh, there we go. A little panic there, I'm not going to lie. All right, let's get our Struthi analyzing. Oh, look at that. When you get a piece of platinum, it is almost erotic. I'm going to hold off just because they're not really filling up the whole thing. I'm going to send out another expedition for some Parasaurolophus. Lovely stuff. I do find the paras a little bit of a pain in the ass sometimes to get. Don't tell them I said that. Right, let's make sure our trikes are going to be happy, first of all. You're not shared with Velociraptor, are you? Am I crazy? You're not shared with... Wait, is that gate open? Yeah, that gate's open. Oh no, I've made it... Okay, I've made a terrible mistake. This was totally my bad. Don't do what I just did. Both my raptors have got in. Oh my god, I was not paying attention to that gate at all. Fly girls, I need you. Quickly, save my trikes. Or save my raptors, it's always hard to tell. You'll be okay, girl. Hold them off. Hold them off. Run. Run for the heavens. Who's quick? I'm going to call you Bolt. There you go. Bolt. Chow. Right, there we go. There's one raptor down. And... Where's the other raptor? can we take care of this problem, please? Fly, girls. Thank you. Okay, so top tip. If you're going to do the stupid thing I did, just because I like the exit animations, don't leave the gates open, okay? Top tip right there. Bet you never would have thought of that on your own. Right, let's pop out some Struthiomimuses as well. I feel dumb, right? I'm trying to showcase how talented I am for YouTube. And then I do what I just did. Okay, we're okay with these, you know, chance to panic, stuff like that. Don't really worry about that stuff. Just grab all of these. They're never going to beat each other up too much anyway. Faster incubation, why not? Oh, the trikes are relatively happy. We need a bit more forest, a bit more ground fiber, but you can see they've not really expanded their environment in the correct direction quite yet. They will get over here, and that'll help them out in a little bit. But we'll get them happier already. And now, even more dinosaurs. Actually, we're going to wait. They're ready to go, which is cool. I'm just going to wait till we've got this challenge done, because if we release the Struthis, it'll get a little bit more difficult kind of thing, so we'll just hold off a little bit. I'm getting ahead of myself, as I am wont to do. Let's get these raptors shim-shem-shimmied out of the way. Hello, girl! Alright, who else is speedy? We've got Bolt. Who else is speedy? Delivery has been completed. Thomas the Tank Engine is speedy. Probably.
Dr. Wu and Dr. Hammond would both like us to increase the diversity of animal species in the park, and then construct a ride where they can be viewed. Make it something impressive.
The fight is very cool. A fight has begun between Bolt and Thomas the Tank Engine. Not a sentence I ever thought I'd hear in my life, it must be said. Can you two just get along? I love that, that the horns pressed together, locked, and then woof, tussled to the ground. Love. Okay, the game crashed, as it happens, but it's okay, we're back in. My second dig team has arrived for the Parasaur, so we're going to send that off as well. There we go. Not quite enough to hit what we need. You can see we need another, what, 10% only. So we're going to head off again. And again, just in case, though, we are going to pick another Parasaur expedition over here. And now that we're on to the next stage, we can release our dinosaurs. Our Struthis are ready to go. But we can also hop over here into research and attractions, and what we need is tour rides. We're going to need that for the next stage of the process. So we're going to... Oh, it's going to be a double. Oh, hurts my soul. There we go. So tour rides on the go. Let's pop out our Stroofies. Big old weirdo chickens. There you go, guys. Now, I believe they need, yeah, quite a lot of different things. Now, of course, they're not in here yet either, so we'll let them get in there and establish their territory before we panic too much about that. There we go. So water should be fine, forest should be fine. They just need a little bit of ground leaf. But, okay, this is my next sort of tip. We're going to add the parasaur soon, and this will not be enough room, okay? We're going to need more space if we're going to get the parasaurs in here. So I'm just going to clear this out so I can see what I'm doing. That's costing an absolute fortune. Don't do that. Did not realize that was so expensive. So what I'm going to do is extend the exhibit out. But what I did last time, when I first played this, I went down this way, right? I naturally expanded this direction. And the problem is, eventually, you're going to want to build out. You're going to need more exhibits. You're going to need more dinosaurs to get that 5-star rating. So you kind of need to think about the future. Terrifying prospect. And what I'm going to do instead is build out this way, okay? And that's going to give us a lot more room to play with later on. By expanding in a different direction and kind of... Instead of having the park kind of sit like a C shape, like this, and limiting ourselves in this part of the map, if we build out here, then we can go all the way down here, we can build there, we can have shops down here through the middle, just give ourselves a little bit more room. You just kind of need to just plan a little bit for the future and you should be okay. This is going to be a very, very funky shape, it must be said. Right, I believe our dig team came back. Hopefully that's enough. It's looking promising. Oh, is it looking promising? Yeah, sweet, okay. God, I'm making a lot of money. I really can't recommend that dig site enhancement enough. Look, these are 900 grand right there. That's crazy money. 900 grand, 220, so that's 111. That's 120 there. 40, 80. We're talking about 1,320,000 just in selling fossils. So, if ever you needed an incentive to do it, there you go right there. Now, I've got to let those build first. I'm going to put a little dink in this. I love a little dink. There we go, there's a little dink. Vehicles aren't under threat, that's silly. Let's check. Our Stroofy's probably not happy. No, they probably need ground leaf. Apparently we have no power. I'll get to that in a second. Let's get some ground leaf. Well, what we'll do, we're going to put it over here. Now, they can't get into it right now, but very soon they'll have access and they'll feel good about themselves, which is all I really want. All my dinosaurs to feel good. As we open up the territory. There we go. A lovely big habitat. It says we have no power, but I think it's probably because we had all those extra fences. It does suggest that the power station... you know what? It's looking okay. Parasaur office. Ready to go. Look at that. Four dinosaurs all ready. Zimmin, zoomin. Faster synthesis. We'll use that. Good opportunity, I think, to give our staff a rest. Now, technically, this is not the most efficient way to do this, because you're spending money, like it always costs the same amount, so if you wait till your staff are absolutely shattered, you'll get more for your money. But it's not too expensive, and I find that just by continuously resting them, you end up being more prepared for the future, essentially. I think it's worth the cost. So, paras on the way. Trikes are no longer happy, because I got rid of some forest, but that's okay. Just put some more over there. I think they'll be happy with that. And we're gonna need some forest over here. I'm gonna need some water over here. The idea is that this bit on the right will be set up more for the paras than the trikes. Okay. And the Stroofies should be hanging around. You're not lonely, you weirdo. Sort of around here, because that's where the leaf is. So we're gonna chuck a little bit of water over there as well. It's nice to build sort of mini habitats within your larger habitat, I think. Right, ready to go. Let's pick some eggs. Thirsty, that's fine. Thirsty, that's fine. Social, that's fine. Okay. Just gonna wait for my staff to finish chilling out at the chill zone. You know, shooting some pool, shooting some b-ball, having a few shots, hooking up in the closet. You know, all those things you do at staff parties. Maybe, having never been to a staff party, I wouldn't have a bloody idea. Faster incubation. I could have a staff party, but it'd be very sad. I do work alone. It'd just be me in a party hat at my desk getting drunk. Actually, that sounds pretty fun. Maybe we'll do that. Right. Raptors happy, Stroofies happy. You need a name, I've decided. You're the leader of the Stroofies, the Alpha and the Omega. I'm going to call you Omega. There you go. I got a fancy name. And let's pop out these parasaurs. Absolutely beautiful. Getting teary-eyed. Love you guys. Right, they're going to need some ground nut, which does sound delicious. So we're going to hop over here, and like I mentioned before, I'm going to kind of dot that around here. The idea is that this will become parasaur territory. However, that looks a little bit boring, so I'm going to chuck some forest in the middle. It's important that your dinosaurs are happy, but it's also important that your exhibits look good, right? Otherwise, what's the point? So... and I'll do some decoration. Well, we'll give them a little time to spread out and hopefully be happy. In the meantime, we've got things to do. We need to set up our park tour, so I tend to do it here on this left-hand side. You need to make sure you're going to have room to slip the path in. You heard me. And I'm going to use the concrete tour track just because it's Jurassic Park, you know? It seems more appropriate to Jurassic Park. And we're going to come through on this side, I think. Set up our Jurassic Park gates, of course. And yeah, I'm going to take the tour. Ooh, there we go. Just kind of go through the habitat. You'll see when I put the water in earlier, I kind of left these gaps very purposefully just so I could then swing the tour through there. Like so. We might need to go back and add more forest and stuff like that and more ground nut, but crash that bridge when we... Oh, no. okay, let me think. I think I want to go this way. So we're going to put another dent in the water here. And... here. And we'll try to get through that bit there. Gotta make it look cool, right? It's not just about success, it's about coolness. Cool things are cool. Okay, and then we need a Jurassic Park gate. Because of course we do. Absolutely every gate must be a Jurassic Park gate. Just hit delete, get rid of that. No! It's not! Oh, it is. Why you lie? It'd be nice if there was like a system in the game where if it was going over water, it could either do that, you know, a little bridge or something, that'd be really cool. Or just, you know, delete the water, basically. Can we get through there? Yeah, looking sexy, looking sexy. Look at that, bingo, blimmin' bango. We're gonna pull this out a little bit. We're gonna do our little curve. Look at my little curve. It will actually latch on very nicely. Straight line. Lovely stuff. Now this will go through and hopefully see all of our dinosaurs. But as I say, we do have to go in and just check. You can see, yeah, the raptors are now missing a little bit of forest because of what we did. So we just need to put a little bit more forest back in there. Make sure the raptors are happy. On the list of dinosaurs to annoy, the raptors are pretty low, it must be said. So let's try to accommodate them as much as possible. It is a little tight because it's a small habitat on purpose, but still, there we go. Happy raptors. And let's check on everyone else. Trikes are looking perfectly happy. Yep, Struthiomimus is looking perfectly happy. Paras, I suspect, not quite. How are you lonely? Oh, they actually need more. Okay, that's fine. We'll make some more paras. Technically, you don't have to do this, but I don't want my dinosaurs to be sad. They will be fine.
We are mere moments away from opening Jurassic Park. And I now hear word we have sick dinosaurs? Someone offer me assurances.
Of course, we're on top of it, Dr. Hammond. We're sending out a mobile veterinary unit from the Paleo Medical Facility even as we speak, aren't we, Lily?
Yes, of course. They'll get us a diagnosis and then we can develop a cure for the Triceratops.
Perfect, we have a plan. That means everything is completely under control. This doesn't even qualify as a minor setback.
Considering all of the obstacles that have been placed before us getting Jurassic Park to this point, I'm inclined to agree. Whatever it takes, see to it. And Henry, let me know the moment this has been resolved. Lily, do carry on.
Thank you. As Dr. Wu said, everything is under control.
Absolutely beautiful stuff. So I kind of messed up. I didn't put ground nut in. So hopefully the paras are going to see that. As you can see, this one has now started to move in that sort of direction. They are lonely, though, and we can't be having that, so let's go ahead and pick another... I don't know how many they need. Did it say the social? No. but we've got a few, so we're just going to grab 3 more. That'll do. There we go. Okay, so Bolt has an undiagnosed ailment, so we're just waiting on our MVUs to get there. What I'm going to do to speed that up in future, though, is just stick a gate there as well. Nice to have more accessibility, basically, rather than having to go all the way around every single time. What are you two? I thought they were fighting there. Right, we've got a disease. So what we need to do is go into our research. Just hit tab, you'll hop straight in there and research IV poisoning. Now, one thing a lot of people have had problems with that I've seen is also the common cold, because you can't cure the common cold, and people get confused by that, which is totally understandable. It really is. All I would say is you can't cure it. The trick with the common cold in this game is simply to... I'm just checking if there's anything else I need right now. I don't think there is. The trick with the common cold is to simply keep healing your dinosaurs. You can't do anything else. I can understand how if your dinosaurs got the common cold right now, it would be super, super rough. What I'd also suggest, because your MVU is stupid, it'll drive home. What we're going to do is we're actually going to manually control it. Look at it. Look at the side of it. That's awesome detail. We're going to manually control it for a little bit. And just kind of sit here, wait for our disease to be researched, and then we can, you know, we can nail them right here, get them cured, get them sorted, and life will be good again. Sorry. I was trying to be dramatic. Ready to shoot you in the face, buddy. Hope you're excited. This does mean you have to wait for the whole thing in normal time, but it does save you time. It doesn't save you real time, but it saves you in-game time. I'd like to point out, I've got 7.5 million in the bank. We have a lot of cash on hand, and the park is very... Bolt. Just gonna back away. The park is... I know. I've backed away. It's okay, buddy. It's okay. You might have to wait a minute. Fire! I miss? I want to shoot over one try to hit the other. Oh, yes! Goals! Absolute life goal. Oh my god, my shooting is on point right now. Have you seen what I just did? I'm really proud of that. Right, so my point is, we have 7.4 million in the bank. Happy, happy dinosaurs.
I'm not sure which is more miraculous. Bringing the dinosaurs back from extinction, or finally opening Jurassic Park to the public. A tribute to us all, and to the glory of dragons.
It's to his ongoing fascination with these prehistoric animals.
May it never die.
True words, Miss Halford. And now, I want to watch the only thing more interesting than the dinosaurs.
What might that be?
Observing people seeing dinosaurs for the first time.
Do 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 do.
Oh, and having an ice cream. Come on then, I'm by.
Do 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 do.
To Jurassic Park.
Do 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 do. Do do dum dum. Usually there'd be music here, but obviously there isn't, and they haven't replaced it with anything. I've had to have obviously licensed music has been turned off.
So far, Jurassic Park has been an almost unqualified success. However, we do want to increase our guest comfort. This can be accomplished by making sure that when nature calls, there is a restroom nearby. Shelters will be appreciated if, and I repeat, this is a big if. If some of our animals escape their enclosures, and the closer our hotels are to the dinosaurs, the more likely it is the guests will enjoy their stay. And we most definitely want that.
Okay. So I'm going to end this video very soon, but the thing I really wanted to show in this video, because I think it's hyper important, is the shops. Now, the game will not suggest you build the shops straight away. It will recommend restrooms, shelter, and accommodation. All very important, but the thing is they're not bringing in the cash. Amenities is how you make your money in this game. So, I've kind of messed up a little bit here. I've kind of made them all the same amenity. You can change it as you go. So, if you do mess up like I do, click configure, click donuts, click other, and click the drink sign there and change it to drink. And all you want is one of all three types, like so. So we're going to make that into a shopping one. Lovely stuff. Now, you want these to be roughly near your viewing gallery and your park tour, stuff like that. And of course, if you hop into management views and you click this button here, you'll see the coverage. Now, it's barely existent right now, but it, oh no. You know, I'll get over that. But it will be later on. So what we're going to do, I just like to do this. There's no reason you have to do this. I would recommend leaving some room, because later on you're going to want to upgrade these for medium-sized amenities. But for now, you can do whatever you want. There we go. So they're not actually making any money right now, so we're just going to chuck in our... I'm just saying that these are important as well. But, you know, the bunker, very important. And the restroom, super important. Sit next to our shops, I think. No, we're gonna put this over here. We'll put the hotel in first, I think. Let's put that there. And let's check in a restroom. There we go. You can actually see the red line right there for where it's most necessary. You should be connected. Yeah, looking good. Speed up time. And hopefully that will be our coverage on the go. You can use the management views to check all this stuff. The only reason I'm not is because I'm assuming this is correct, basically, because that's where our viewing is. So that's where people will go, basically. And already you can see research available, improved amenities, which is what we want. So let's get that on the go right away. I'm going to stick everyone on that one because I want it to be ASAP. Super important. Medium amenities are a big, big deal. No, Bolt, sick bro, no! That's not sick bro. That's not sick bro at all. God, that is beautiful looking though, isn't it? Look how dramatic this is. I feel like I should be commentating on a boxing match or something. It looks so good! Someone's about to take a tumble. Who is it? Oof. Dun dun dun. Alright, one of you's probably a bit injured, aren't they? Wow, oddly enough, they're okay. Weird. Really? Okay, so if you've got this where your restroom coverage isn't great or shelter coverage isn't great, hit management views and shelter is in the top left. So it's probably down here. Yep, you can see we need a few more. I did mention we'll have to build things over here at some point. So all you're going to want to do is grab your bunker. Boop. Grab your restroom. Unfortunately, going to need a little bit of power down here. Why the emergency bunker doesn't need power, but the restroom does, I'm not sure. I mean, in terms of my priorities, I'd give them to the bunker, personally, but as a ugly pylon placement right there, I might move that for my own sanity. That does seem a bit weird, doesn't it? It's a bit bizarre. Improved amenities, so I'm going to do something a little bit crazy. Ah, you can see we're now running out of power, right? Because our little baby power station, it's tried its best, but it is... Wait, what? Wait, why am I out of power? I need a minute to figure this one out. Why am I out of power? Have I been using you? I have been, actually. These haven't got a thing. Substation. That would be why. Okay, so we're going to do something a little daft. You kind of need the amenities in initially to kind of get this going. Maybe you don't. Maybe you never have to build these amenities. No, this...
We need to make sure our guests' needs are catered for. Let's build some amenities to help with that.
What you want are big amenities.
If our guests' appetites aren't taken care of.
Big, chunky amenities. Much better. Much, much better. And what you can do, click medium amenity. We just built a toy shop, so we're going to build a drink shop. Just click that button there. And honestly, medium amenities are a big deal. Large ones, less of a big deal. But really, I just want the amenities going so I can show you how to do amenities correctly, because it's super, super important to make lots of money that you nail the amenities. And this needs changing. Let's go ahead and delete that as well. Okay, so you can see that our coverage over here means our overall coverage is fine. Right, that's the other thing I want to talk about. So. Wide path. This will pop up at some point when you've hit a certain guest number. I really recommend you research this as well. We're just going to stick a couple people on that. And this is why. So if we hop into this screen right here, go to our guests. You can see here, we've got this dotted line here, that's your path capacity, and yours will probably look like this at this point in time, you know, nearly an hour in, about 50 minutes or so. And you can see that's our guest count has begun to go up. Now that the park's open, we've got our restroom coverage, we've got our shelter coverage, and very soon our amenities, that we've now hit this point here, and we've got overcrowding, and although our potential guests is all the way up here, 927, because of our low path capacity, our guest number can't get that high. So you want to research the wide paths ASAP. And whilst that's going on, I will show you the amenities. So this is how amenities work. Get yourself a medium one. It is easier, I promise. You can do this with the low ones, but not to the same extent. And what we're trying to do, this is actually a bit rough. I think they've maybe changed this a little bit. But what we're trying to do is get all these crosses here to be ticks. Okay, that's our goal right now. So this one's fine. It covers several things. I think I'll change it to leisure wear, just because those numbers are higher than the grey one. And all we're going to do is use these interior modules here to try to get those numbers higher. Now, we should be able to do this in two. So we can chuck in a gift stand. That's going to get both of those. And we're looking for a green and grey one, as you can see, because those are both in the X's. And get the skeleton display. Done. That is it. Do not do anything else, okay? And that is literally how you do an amenity. That's all it takes. Don't fill up all these slots. It's absolutely pointless. All you're trying to do is hit these tick markers, and that is literally it. So we'll do the same again over here with the bubble tea. La bubble tea. We're going to go on a general one again, just because that's what we've got more of. It doesn't really matter, if I'm totally honest. And again, so that was pretty good. So that's quite a cheap one. You can see they cost different amounts, and the ones that do little effects, you can see a little tick here, that's how much impact they're having. The fountain has a little impact, but it's enough, just enough to get us the two ticks. So we're going to stick a fountain in, and now we need maybe a photo booth, or this. We can see we get more profit. Look, keep an eye on your profit down here. Photo booth takes us to 10k, that takes us to 8.5, so that's obviously better. Selfie spot a little bit higher, so get that. There you go, 10.5. And to prove the point, if we now add another one, because, you know, maybe you want to fill these bars a little higher, you can see all of these will actually reduce the profit we get from our amenities. I really think this is why people aren't making any money, generally speaking. We're going to do the same thing one more time. Doesn't really matter. This doesn't really matter, this one here. It's these interior modules that are key. And we're trying to get two at once. So let's get an ice cream machine and a water feature. There we go. So again, all ticks. You should be able to do it in two modules. The reason we use medium amenities is that you have better modules that will more likely guarantee that you get those tick markers. Okay, I'm going to speed up time to show you one last thing. I should have noticed that this was draining over time because we didn't have a power station here and this was funding these. So I'm going to keep that just in case, but whatever. Okay, so this is really cool. I really want to show you this in action. And I think once you get to this point, it's pretty easy. There's not much else to do after this point that I think would be a struggle. I do have to make a small amenity for this, rather annoyingly. And we also need to research a guest attraction, which is in here, question mark? Oh, guest attractions. Oh, probably in the attraction section, I guess. Now, I've got to say, we have to build one of these. I never worry about them too much. Maybe they make really good money. Maybe that's something I'm going to learn as we play through this Chaos Theory. We'll try that out in the next video. But in my experience, they're not vital or anything. But maybe they are. We'll try it out. So, research done, wide path. So, as I say, you've got your park open, you've got your shops in, you've got your shelters in, you've got your toilets in. Wide path should be the next thing you get. And again, if we come over here, you can see our potential guest is super high, but we're stuck here. And all we're going to do is we're going to hit the path button. We're going to click replace on here. We're going to hit wide path, and we're going to go along this main route right here. Place, it will cost you a bit of cash. Replace all of these with wide paths, and we'll do it to the shops as well. But really the important bit is that you get this this main through fare here. I'm just going to link together all my things, generally speaking. There we go. Now, I'm going to hit play. Prepare yourselves. Everything comes back online, right? Everything kind of recharges a little bit. I'm going to sell my backup generator just because I hate that icon popping up all the time. And I'm going to resupply this, because this we do have to resupply. Okay, now we're going to click our star rating. And we're going to go to guests. And already you can see we've got 790. Look at my guest numbers! Look at how much they have jumped up in no time at all. just because we made the paths wider. And that doesn't just, you know, affect our guest numbers, but more guests, of course, means our income. Now, 27k, 23k, 27k, suddenly our shops are making an absolute fortune. And we still don't have all of the guests we need. You can see here, if we click this again, that our guest comfort isn't quite perfect because our accommodation rating is pretty low. So all we need to do is stick in another hotel. Stick it in over here. Hotels, by the way, don't, as far as I can tell, have to be in a specific location. I believe you can put them anywhere and they work fine. And keep in mind, I'm going to fix all these. So why not? I've got the money. Hey, but keep in mind that you will get an even thicker path later on in the research. Now, as with the large amenities to the medium ones, it's less important, or medium to large, I should say. But generally speaking, the point is you can make this even thicker down the line. And now the park is open. We're over 2 stars already. We've got a happy park, loads of guests, making a killing, 154 already. You know, we've barely got started, really. And yeah, we're into like a really good start for challenge mode. You can see my path capacity is above my potential guest count, and that's really what you want. And you can see here that our actual guest count and our potential guest count are basically hitting each other, which again is what you want. Path capacity, ladies and gentlemen, path capacity is hypo important. And that is how I would recommend kicking things off. Now we're going to put our attraction in and a small amenity, which we'll then destroy because it's pointless. But you know, now if you want to expand further, all we're going to do is we're going to keep adding more dinosaurs. And anywhere that we desperately need shops, by checking on our management screen, we'll then add some shops in that area using the same philosophy we did here. Now, over the coming days, I will continue this Chaos Theory mode. Of course, we're going to play through it. I'm going to be a little bit more chill going forward. I really wanted this to serve as a helpful guide to people as well. So we'll be a little bit more chilled, a little bit less guide-focused going forward, but you will see me complete the entire thing and get 5 stars. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. Hopefully you folks are too. Hopefully if you've been struggling, this will help. I think if you can just follow me to this point, you're now very well set up for the future at the very least. You know, it's hard for things to go too wrong from here. I mean, they definitely can, but this is, I think, a really good base. We've got lots of money, good star rating, good income. Everything you'd want, really. Sound good? Sound good? Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Please do throw me a like if you enjoyed this video, and let me know in the comment section if it, you know, it helps you, if you learned anything. I'm trying to be a helpful resource. And I'll see you lovely folks next time. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.